arithmetico geometric series, a series which consists of AP as well as GP is known as arithmetico geometric series. We are developing a technique to solve the problems of AGP. I am just taking one example. 2 into 3 plus 4 into 3 square plus 6 into 3 cube plus up to another term is this. See here, 2, 4, 6 is in AP, whereas 3 square, 3 cube is in GP. So this is AGP. I am telling you the technique how to solve AGP problems, how to find the sum of AGP problem. I am finding here the nth term. Each term is consisting of two things, one AP and one GP. The nth term of the GP will be, see here, 2, 4, 6 in AP. So the nth term of this will be 2 plus n minus 1 into D is 2. And nth term of the GP will be 3 to the power n. So the nth term of the GP is this. What technique I follow? I multiply this S with the common ratio of the GP, which is coming out to be 3 here. 3 square, 3 cube. So the common ratio is 3 here. On multiplying this with 3, the first term is coming out to be 2 into 3 square. That I am writing leaving one place. So it is coming out to be 2 into 3 square. When second term is multiplied with 3, this is coming out to be 4 into 3 cube. 4 into 3 cube. Like that. And as I have left one place here, so I have to move one place extra here. So it will be, the nth term is 2n into 3 to the power n. So it will be 2n. Solve it. It is coming out to be 2n into 3 to the power n into 3 is 3 to the power n plus 1. Just subtract this. Very easy technique I am giving you. That is the universal technique. You will solve all the problems very easily. On subtracting, you are getting here minus 2s. And here, just see, first place is left as it is. And the last place is left as it is. Okay? In between, the subtraction is going on with how many terms? N terms was total. I have left one term. So the subtraction process is in n minus 1 terms. This is very important. Remember, n minus 1 terms are taking part here. On subtraction, it is giving you 2 into 3 square plus 2 into 3 cube plus so on. How many terms? Very important, n minus 1 terms. See, by following this process, we are getting the result in GP. And we can find the sum of the GP very easily. First term to be left as it is. It is GP. So sum of GP is A, that is 2 into 3 square, R to the power N, which is 3 here. N, number of terms is N minus 1, minus 1 by R minus 1. That is 3 minus 1, that is 2, plus, that is 2N, into 3 to the power n plus 1. So we can get easily the value of S, that is the sum of the AGP, which is coming out to be minus 1 by 2 of whole thing. And the whole thing is 2 into 3 plus 2 into 3 square, 3 to the power n minus 1, minus 1, by 2, and this minus 1 by 2 is with everything, plus 2n into 3 to the power n plus 1. See, this is KZB. Now I will go for some special sequence sum. Special sequence sum, you just remember such a formula. Summation n is n into n plus 1 by 2. Summation n square is n, n plus 1, 2n plus 1 by 6. And summation n cube is n, n plus 1 by 2 whole square. You just remember three formula. We'll make use of this formula while finding the sum of special series. Suppose the nth term of a series is n square plus 3n. And I have to find the sum of that series for n terms. What is the formula? You just understand this formula very clearly. This Sn is summation of Tn, which is going out to be summation of n square plus 3 into summation of n. I'm just explaining why Sn is equal to summation of Tn. See here, what is actually Sn? Sn is actually sum of all terms, S1 plus S2. I'm just writing sum of all terms A1 plus A2 plus A3 up to A. Sum of all terms here. Sum of all terms is written as summation of An or Tn, whatever we want to write. So, if we know the nth term, summation is going to be, summation of that series is going to be sum of Tn. So, S is summation of Tn. So, in that particular case, I have taken this thing. It is going to be summation n square is n, n plus 1, 2n plus 1, by 6, plus 3, and summation of n is n into n plus 1, by 2. We can find the sum of the series. All the times we are not getting the nth term. We have to find the nth term as well in some of the problem. Suppose I am giving you a problem. 2 into 3 plus 4 into 5 plus 6 into 7. Like that, a series is going on. You identify the pattern. What it is? It is consisting of two terms. First term, 2, 4, 6, which is in AP. Second term, 3, 5, 7 is also in AP. So, nth term of the series is product of two APs, first AP and second AP. What is the nth term of the first AP? You will see that is 2 plus n minus 1 into 2. Is it A plus n minus 1 into D? And the nth term of the second AP is 3 plus n minus 1 into 2. So what it is going to be, see here, it is just 2n into, it's going to be 2n plus 1. Is it? Yeah. On simplifying, it is going to give you 4n square plus 2n. Once we got Tn, we can find Sn easily. So Sn is summation of Tn. So it is 4 summation of n square plus 2 summation of n, and we can just put the value and get the sum of this particular series. One more method I am discussing here, this is very important, known as difference method. Suppose a problem is given like 1 by 3 into 5 plus 1 by 5 into 7 plus 1 by 7 into 9. Super. Firstly, follow what pattern is there, is that in the series. So, I'm finding to nth term of a series, which is actually 1 divided by product of two things. What is the pattern? Two things are following, 3, 5, 7 in AP, and the second terms 5, 7, 9 in second AP. Yes? So this is product of two APs. So I'm finding the nth term of first AP, which is 3 plus n minus 1 into 2 in 2. 5 plus n minus 1 into 2. So it is going to be 1 by 2n plus 1, and here 1 by 2n plus 3. So nth term we got, we have to find sum of the n terms. For such type of problem, we go for partial fraction. Partial fraction is an algebraic operation where two things are there, two or more than two things are there in the product. We separate them. That can be easily separated. I am giving you a technique. You just subtract the bigger term from the smaller in the numerator. See what is happening. On solving, you will get that in the numerator, 2 is there. But actually 1 was there and it is coming up to be 2, so I will divide it by 2. Ultimately, the series is going to be the pattern I am writing. Separating it, it will give you 1 by 2. This thing divided by complete will give you 1 by 2n plus 1 minus 1 by 2n plus 3. Now, very easy. We'll follow the basic thing. Sn is what? T1 plus T2 plus T3 up to Tn. Sum of all the terms. That actually we will be doing here. See, T1 can be found out easily by putting n equal to 1 in the given expression. It is coming out to be 1 by, if I am putting 1, 1 by 3 minus 1 by 5. Second term is going out to be 1 by, if I am putting here 2, that is going to be 1 by 5 minus 1 by, I am putting here 2, 7. Third term is like that, 1 by 7 minus 1 by 9. So on, the process is going on, and the nth term is 1 by 2n plus 1 minus 1 by 2n plus 3. See here, this term, this second term is getting cancelled out with the first term of the next item. The process is going on. So ultimately, we will be left over with the first term, that is 1 by 3 minus the last term, which is going out to be 1 by 2n plus 3. To simplify, you will get this. This is one of the example of the difference method.
For useful videos, log on to my channel Santosh Bimbi on YouTube or directly go to my website www.mathsonphone.com. Thank you.